try and teach a little bit of off spin to start off with. It's not something that's perfect to the manual, but this is what works for me. First thing first, with the ball, I'm going to show you a little bit of the grip that works for me. So an off spin grip is essentially something that comfortably sits on the seam. It could range from anywhere between the index finger being parallel to perpendicular with the ball, so it can go up till here depending on the comfort of the hand on the particular ball and the fingers going neatly wrapping the ball across. So as much as the ball gets wrapped around the ball, the chances of this ball being spun more and the revs being more is pretty higher. As you cock your index finger into the ball, the chances of top spin is very high because the ball is going to come out like this. And when the index finger is like cutting across the seam in a parallel fashion to the ball, then it's going to go in such a fashion where the ball is about 45 degrees towards the batsman. So what induces more spin and more break is the one that's 45 degrees facing towards the batsman, and the one that's slightly tilted towards the 90 degree mark where the seam position is somewhere like this and not exactly like this is when you get the extra bounce. So it varies. I use this particular grip to induce more top spin on the ball where my index finger is like a hook, and for me to bore more side spin, I try and hook the index finger like in a parallel position to the ball's surface. So this is how I go about producing my off spin. And the more revs is imparted by the wrist position over the ball. The wrist essentially needs to finish in this fashion for the ball to go in the 45 degree panel that it's required. And the faster the rotation goes of the wrist, the better it is for the ball to produce more dip and drift on the ball. The other one which actually got me famous is the carom ball. So this is not something that's very easy because the ball doesn't... I started bowling it with a tennis ball, wherein the tennis ball actually gets pressed with my middle finger. The tennis ball actually goes into that position where I can hold it around with my thumb, and then I produce that carom ball position wherein you actually hit a striker. So when you do that, what happens is with the squeeze, the tennis ball dips and it turns. But with a cricket ball, it's that much more harder. I try and get it to squeeze in like this with my thumb knuckled around the seam, and my index finger, depending on how much revolution and how much pace I want to use, I release my index finger or put it on top of the ball. From here on, I just use my middle finger as a striker and push the striker like this. So the ball starts rotating, and if I want to produce more revs and slow the ball down, I try and put the index finger like this, and if I want to really bowl it flatter, I press it on the ball and try and reduce the revolutions for the trajectory to be flatter. So that's pretty much how the carom ball is bowled. If I want to reduce the trajectory on the ball, so for instance, let's say I want to still slow the ball down but not put it through it in the air and the trajectory needs to be flatter, I try and use my arm length, which is my lever. If it's generally coming at close to 90 degrees, I try and push it a little wider, wherein the ball induces a little bit of an undercut. But I can use it to like really reduce the trajectory and still keep the slowness going. And the other variation that I use is the arm ball. The arm ball is pretty much an outswinger, bowled with a single finger, the index finger. I try and take this middle finger out of the equation. The grip is the same, the action is the same. Try and release the thumb away from the seam a little bit. Try and produce this kind of a wrist position and try and have some backspin on the ball. So once this happens, the ball travels in direction, the seam travels in direction with the second slip facing this way, and it just swings out in the arc. So if I cock my wrist and release the ball from behind, the ball swings a little later, and if I want to push it through and try and reduce the swing and cut the time for the batsman, then try and use the wrist in a cocking position and try and not completely uncock it. Just use it in a straight position, just release the ball. So this is how I go about using my arm ball. The arm ball is an effective mask for the off spin with the same grip, and it really gives me another dimension to the game. So there are a few variations that goes inside my own system. Like, these are the cues for me to actually bowl my variations in terms of pace. The pace variation is entirely using the revs and a little bit of your body. So if I want to still bowl slow and not give batsman much time in the air, I try and use my body weight in front. I don't really rock back much. I try and keep my weight in front. And if I, these are all personal cues. You can't find them in the manual. These are just cues that I use. But if I want to really induce a little bit of flight and drop and dip, then I try and really rock back and then finish the action really well. So what actually helps me in using these flights really well is the angles of the crease. I use the crease much better than I used to before. What I do essentially at the crease is try and create different angles. So let's just say from round the stumps, if I go wide of the crease, it's going to create that kind of a geometry. It's going to create an angle which is very, very difficult for the left-hander to play, because it's going to keep coming at the pads, and even if it straightens, it's going to look like this much of a spin. So that's essentially what I try and do with the crease. And if I get close to the stumps for a left-hander, it's again going to create a very, very different arc. the left hander from here needs to open up to really find my ball, so which gives me a very good chance to nick him off. And very, very similar to the right hander. Right hander, I go wide of the crease to create a bit of an angle for the ball to go to short leg. If there's not much in the wicket, I try and use the wide of the crease angle to actually get them lunging forward. Or even when they go back, they actually think the ball's actually coming at a pretty good pace and it's not going to break. But it's not the break that induces the edge.